Police are dealing with another strange death, so we're asking your secret paranormal police department for help. Forensics says the cause of death was cardiac arrest. The victim is a young actress at the local theater, but she's not in our database. It's like she doesn't exist. Make sure you call Eleanor. This case could use some of your twin magic. I'll meet you at the theater.
This is First Lieutenant Randall Jones. My sister Eleanor and I are going to investigate Adeline Southfield's death. So far we have a rose, a ticket, a piece of cordon tape, and Lawrence Grayfield's testimony. Police found a glove, a handkerchief with the initials A.L., and a feathered boa. I should read Laura Phillips' statement to find out more. Laura says Adeline and Andreas had an argument before their performance. That gives us a potential motive. Herman Cloverfeld's deposition mentions a knife and glasses with Andreas's fingerprints.
I just talked to Officer Edward Schopenhauer. He asked us to take an unusual case about an actress named Adeline Salfield. It's a complex case, so he needs my logic and deduction skills and your paranormal abilities to see beyond the surface. Meet Officer Schopenhauer at the theater. Call the theater to get the address.
Help me!
Thank you.
can't let a black cat cross my path before starting a new case. I have to make the threshold clear of bad omens before I cross it. Hurry, detective. I don't recognize that spirit. Could she be the victim in this new case?
You've reached the Modern Art Theater. We're located at 33 Freedom Street. Our operating hours are 8 a.m. to 11 p.m. For show times, please.
Thank you.
Thank you for coming so quickly. Yesterday, we examined Adeline Salfeld's body on the stage where she fell. From what we can tell, her heart just stopped beating. The forensic analysis couldn't tell what caused it, but it's unusual for someone her age. Your abilities with your brother's deduction will help us piece together what happened. Here, this is another piece of evidence.
Spirits! I knew there was something strange about this death. Hopefully my visions will show me what happened.
Thank you. Are you insane? Of course I don't believe you. You're not 100 years old, and you weren't on the St. Mary. You're speaking nonsense. I see what's going on. You're seeing someone else. That's why you rejected me. I'll kill you both. If I can't be with you, no one will.
Summon Adeline's spirit at this altar.
My name is Catherine Lisbeth, but I was known as Adeline. I don't know how I died, but I believe I was killed. I suddenly felt sick when I was on stage with Andreas, and then my heart stopped. I survived the sinking of the St. Mary in 1912. I was in that cold water for so long that I was clinically dead, but I still survived. After that, I stopped aging. I reflected on my life and decided to fulfill my dream of becoming an actress. So I changed my name to Adeline and started over as a new person. When I came to this town, Andreas and I met and fell in love. But my history and condition kept me from having a serious relationship. I decided to tell him the truth, but he didn't believe me. Who would? He thought I was cheating on him. He got angry and said a lot of terrible things, but I don't believe he killed me. I hope knowing my story helps you find the real killer.
I didn't do anything! You can't pin this on me! I'm calling my lawyer! You have nothing on me. I didn't kill Adeline. It was a part of the show. I don't deny that I threatened her, but I didn't really mean it. I loved her more than anything. Did you talk to Ingrid? She's Adeline's stand-in and her main rival for the lead role. I'm surprised you haven't questioned her. She's at the hospital with a severe allergic reaction, but you should visit her. I'm sorry I acted so impulsively, Detective. Now, I have work to do, but here, take this as an apology.
Eleanor, I questioned Andreas. He told me that Adeline had a rival named Ingrid. I'm going to the hospital to talk to her, but keep in touch.
shouldn't have come here, Detective. You're the key witness, and you'll do perfectly as my new test subject.
Thank you.
Eleanor, it's Randall. I've been kidnapped.
I'm surprised you were able to get out of the van.
No matter. You won't be needing this anymore.
Find your brother. Perform the ritual with the map and pendant.
Oh, the crossroad is the perfect place to perform the ritual. Something terrible must have happened here a long time ago. There's so much negative energy. I think incense can chase away the malevolent presence. Now I can enter.
it's you. Thanks. That crazy doctor was in Ingrid's room and injected me with something to knock me out. Be careful. He's dangerous. I looked around and realized that I could get out through the vent. Please, bring me something sharp. This might help.
Wonderful catch of the day. Miss, please come to my office. You'll be my guest. Okay, you win. I'm Stanley Brown, the former head of this hospital. I started experimenting on people when this facility was closed. I was in Ingrid's ward because some strange man hired me to kill her. When everything went wrong, he told me to get rid of you. That's really all I know.
Thank you.
Yeah, you saw how I sold this concoction to some B-level actress. A competitor of your dead Adeline. I found the potion recipe in an alchemy book and tested it on my patients to achieve the necessary result. Just look at these photos.
I know who he's talking about. We should check Ingrid's house. First, I'll call the police. This lunatic is dangerous. Randall, follow her. I'll check the house.
Wow, I was expecting to see Miss Ingrid Bischow. I'm Kelly Parker, a journalist for Paranormal Today. I followed you and your brother to the theater. Then I went to Ingrid's house to find clues that prove she's guilty. Rumor has it, she was jealous of Adeline. If you don't turn me into the police, I'll hack her mail. You just need to find the password. Here, this might help.
I loved going to the... and watching the... When I went home, I would wear my mother's... and imagine that I was an actress. After the theater degree, I worked hard and achieved my first success. The applause in the hall was proof of it. I also met my first... the theater director. My life ran out when a new actress named Adeline took the cast, and she not only took my lead role, but also my love, Andreas. Using the alchemical, I'll get revenge on her, and everything will go back to normal. It may seem, but I'm ready for anything. Her will be the price.
Poison Adeline with a potion? What does it mean to take her youth? This is more serious than I thought. Andreas could escape at any moment. I can go to your brother and tell him everything about Andreas and Ingrid's conspiracy. You should hurry to Andreas's house to press charges and make sure he stays put.
What led you to me? We had a perfect plan. It doesn't matter anymore. You caught me red-handed. I'll confess in court. I just can't live like this anymore. Only, I need your help with something. Can you bandage my leg and take me to the hospital? I think I twisted it. And take this. It might come in handy.
Good evening, Mr. Jones. I'm Kelly Parker, a local journalist. Eleanor told me about your investigation. I came here to tell you that Andreas was behind all of it. We read it in an email between him and Ingrid. He's far more dangerous than he seems. Eleanor went to stop him from escaping. She might already be there. You should hurry.
I should plant a bug on the car in case he tries to escape. He protected his house against intruders. If I put sugar over it, I'll be able to go inside.
I never expected you to work so quickly. It's all the doctor's fault. He failed to get rid of Ingrid and missed you both. Ah, well, I'm about to leave the country, and then nobody will find me.
Thank you.
It's the cabinet with Andreas's documents. I think I can find evidence there if I scan this place with something that belongs to Andreas.
I underestimated you, but a couple of amateur detectives won't ruin my plans.
Thank you. I found Andreas's plane ticket, his false documents, and Adeline's money. We need to be quick and follow him. I planted a bug on his car so we can find him. But first, we need to find a charger for my phone. Here, this might help. Randall. Find a way to neutralize him.
Hi, Eleanor. It's me, your colleague, Carlos. I can't contact your brother because he's working on another case undercover. Our investigation has hit a dead end. We can't catch a serial killer called the Fisherman. I need to ask for your help.
I'll help you find who you're looking for. Summon my spirit.
Thank you.
My name's Hazy Brooksby. I'm Charles's wife. I don't know who killed me, but it wasn't an accident. Some lunatic was stalking me and always hanging around my car. When I was murdered, they put my car into the river to cover it up. Listen, I know that the murder weapon is somewhere nearby. I'll help you find the killer if you find it. Here, it'll help. Eleanor. With this evidence, the police will quickly uncover the truth. I'll show you exactly where my body is. This fisherman usually left his victims' bodies in the water. Oh, look! What's this? Take it. It might be useful.
Found a body? I'll be right over.
I did a genetic analysis and sent it to forensics. Please take a photo of her tattoo to make sure the body's correctly identified. Oh, your phone's dead? You can charge it in my car. Meanwhile, I'll examine the body. The analysis confirmed that it's Hazy Brooksby. I was working on her case and suspected her husband, Charles. Unfortunately, I didn't have any evidence to press charges. Now we can question him again.
Please help! Save Agatha.
I found this here. It proves that Charles knew all the victims. He took their stuff as souvenirs. I'll go to the hospital to interrogate him when he comes around. Check the house. Maybe you'll find something that leads to Agatha. can't help but notice. All the girls look like my mother. I remember my first victim. Her long dark hair and sapphire-colored eyes. They drove me crazy. I won't let them become wives. If they do, they'll leave their homes and abandon their children. Just thinking about it breaks my heart. My surveillance of each victim was thorough. I knew their cars, numbers, and where they lived. I knew the route to each one. I was rewarded for my efforts. I take care of my trophies, just like I took care of my puppy.
Great, now we know where Agatha is. Go to her while I keep an eye out for Charles.
I've got a bad heart. Please help me, and I'll tell you about Charles. Bring me a sedative pill.
Thank you.
I'm George, a local fisherman.
Oh, you're looking for Agatha?
I saw Charles with some girl a few days ago. It seemed like she didn't want to go with him. I thought they were just having a lover's quarrel. If I had known she was one of the missing girls, I would have told the police. Unfortunately, I don't know who pushed me. You can take my boat if you want to cross the lake. I'll get it ready. Please, find that killer. He's terrorized this place for way too long.
True.
Hi, I'm Agatha. Charles hid me here to protect me from the serial killer. He was the only one who believed I was being stalked. Someone was following his wife over a year ago, and then she went missing. He's still looking for her and doesn't trust anyone. That's why Charles decided to help me.
You shouldn't have come here, Eleanor. Now I'll have to get rid of you. I didn't want to hurt you, but you know too much. Unfortunately, you're not my type. I'll deal with you later. I'll just repair my car and take you both to my secret hideout.
Thank you. Please get rid of that madman. I'll try to escape. Good luck. Thank you.
I'm so grateful. Now I can finally leave this world for the next.